亲爱的弟兄姐妹，大家早安。
Good morning, brothers and sisters.
我们又在空中见面了。
We meet online again.
感谢主，大家都健康。
Praise God, everybody is healthy.
我们真的每一天活着都是上帝的恩典。
Truly, it's by the grace of God that we are all living.
今天是主日圣餐。
Today is the Holy Communion.
让我们一起来看一段经文。
Let us together look at the scripture.
就是在哥林多前书十一章二十三节。
That's in 1 Corinthians chapter 11 verse 23.
我们先读华文，再读英文哈。我当日所领受的，所传给你们的，就是主被卖的那一切，拿起饼来祝谢了，说：“这是我的身体，为你们而舍的。”你们应当如此行，为的是纪念我。饭后也照样拿起杯来说：“这是我的身体，为你。”这是也拿起杯来说：“这是我的宝血所立的新约。你们每逢喝这杯，是表明主的死，只等到我再来。”
1 Corinthians chapter 11 verse 23. For I received from the Lord.What I also delivered to you, that the Lord Jesus, on the night when he was betrayed, took bread, and when he had given thanks, he broke it and said, This is my body, which is for you. Do this in remembrance of me. In the same way also, he took the cup after supper, saying, This cup is the new covenant in my blood. Do this as often as you drink it in remembrance of me. For as often as you eat this bread and drink the cup, you proclaim the Lord's death until he comes.
所以我们看到圣经很清楚的知道，我们吃这个饼喝这个杯是表明主的死，是纪念我们的主耶稣，然后我们在主里面是一家人，我们用耐心彼此等候耶稣基督的再来。
So the Bible clearly tells us that we are together as part of the body of Christ and patiently we await the second coming of our Lord Jesus.
所以我们一起为这个饼跟这个杯祷告，我们一起领受这个饼跟这个杯。
Let's pray and then together we partake this bread and this cup.
我们一起祷告。天父，我们谢谢你。
Father, we thank you.
谢谢你赐下耶稣为我们死在十字架上。
Thank you for sending Jesus to die on the cross for us.
担当了我们所有的罪。
That he bear all our sins.
承受了我们所有的咒诅。
And he took all the curses on behalf of us.
耶稣所流的宝血。
All the blood shed by Jesus.
洗净了我们一切的罪恶。
Cleanse us from all sins.
让我们在耶稣里面成为神的儿子。
So that we are children in the sight of God.
谢谢主耶稣。
Thank you, Jesus.
为我们所做的一切
For everything that you have accomplished for us.
我们带着感恩的心一起来领受这个饼跟这个杯
With a heart of thanksgiving, we partake this bread and this cup.
奉耶稣的名祷告
In Jesus' name we pray.
我们一起来领受这个饼跟杯
Let's together partake the bread and the cup.
好，我们感谢神，我们要在这个月份里面，我们会讲到家庭，讲到婚姻。
Thank God that in this month we can talk about family and we can talk about marriage.
因为这个月是母亲节，下个月是父亲节，所以我们会在这个月里面注重这个婚姻的课题，然后还有就是家庭祷告的课题。
Because this month is the Mother's Day and next month is Father's Day. So in our sermon, we will talk more about family and talk more about our marriage.
我们一起来祷告。
Let us pray.
天父，我们谢谢你。
Father, we thank you.
谢谢你让我们有家庭，有家人。
Thank you that we are all have a family.
因为我们看到这是你所设立的。 旨意。
Because we see that this is the will that you have established.
我们为着今天来感谢你。
We thank you for today.
我们为着我们每一位家人来感恩。
We thank you for every single family, every single members.
这时候我们要把这今天交托在恩主的手中。
This moment we just commit today unto your hands.
求主帮助我们认识婚姻的观念。
Help us to understand and to know the perspective and the views on marriage and family.
让我们更活出神你的美好旨意。
So that we can live out your glorious will.
奉耶稣的名祷告。
In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
Amen.
所以当我们讲婚姻的时候，我们要从创世纪跟哥林多前书来看。
So when we talk about marriage, we want to look from Genesis and from 1 Corinthians.
所以我们讲婚姻，其实婚姻是一门很深奥的一个学问。
So when we talk about marriage, actually it is a very profound knowledge.
尤其是夫妻关系
especially the relationship between husband and wife.
至于如何维持一个婚姻，是我们讲的一种生活的一种技巧。
And how to maintain this relationship, this marriage, is a skill.
另外一个就是婚姻其实是一种彼此享受的过程。
Another point is marriage is actually a process of enjoying one another.
还有婚姻是一种委身的一个承诺。
And it's a commitment to one another.
婚姻是彼此的付出和牺牲。
And marriage requires us giving and sacrificing for one another.
所以当我们对婚姻有一个正确的观念的时候，我们就比较容易说在婚姻里面，我们知道怎样去维持，怎样去保守我们的婚姻。
So when we have the right perspective on marriage, then we know how to maintain our marriage and how to protect it.
所以我们从创世纪二章十八到二十节来看。
So we look from Genesis chapter 2 verses 18 to 20.
耶和华神说，那人独居不好。我要为他造一个伴侣，帮助他。耶和华神用土所造的各地，野地各样走兽和空中各样飞鸟，都带到那人面前，看他叫什么名字，那人怎样叫各样的活物，那就是他的名字。那人便给一切牲畜和空中的飞鸟、野地走兽都起了名。只是那人没有遇见配偶帮助他。
Verse 18, later the Lord God said, it is not good for the man to be alone. I will make for him a companion that is a suitable match for him. After the Lord God formed from the ground every wild animal and every bird that flies, he brought each of them to the man to see what he would call it. Whatever the man called each living creature became its name. The man gave names to all the livestock.To the birds that fly, and to each of earth's animals, but there was not found for the man any companion corresponding to him.
然后，创世纪二章二十一节，他就说，耶和华使他沉睡，他就睡了。于是取下他的一条肋骨，又把肉合起来。二十二节，耶和华就用那人身上所取的肋骨造成一个女人，领。他到那人跟前，那人说：“这是我骨中的骨，肉中的肉，可以称她为女人，因为她是从男人身上取出来的。因此，人要离开父母，与妻子联合，两人成为一体。”
And then in verses 21 to 24, it says, "So the Lord God caused a deep sleep to overshadow the man. When the man was asleep,He removed one of the man's ribs and closed up the flesh where it had been. Then the Lord God formed the rib that he had taken from the man into a woman and brought her to the man. So the man exclaimed, At last, this is bone from my bones and flesh from my flesh. This one will be called woman because she was taken from man. Therefore, a man will leave his father and his mother and cling to his wife, and they will become one flesh.
So, 我们今天要分享的第一点，我们必须清楚的知道，神是婚姻是神所设立的。
So today, the first point that we want to bring out is that marriage is established by God.
圣经中有关于婚姻的几点重要的教训。
There are several important lessons about marriage in the Bible.
婚姻既然是神所设立的。
And marriage is established by God.
是一种男女之间可以称为一种神圣。而且一种极为亲密的一种关系。
It's a relationship between man and woman that is sacred and also intimate.
另外，圣经有讲到，人人都当尊重婚姻。
And then a part of scripture also says that everyone should respect it.
就是在希伯来书十三章第四节。
That's from Hebrews chapter 13 verse 4.
我们要看看当初神为什么设立婚姻呢？他的目的是什么
？Want to look at the purpose? Why did God establish marriage in the first place?
首先，神认为那人独居不好。
First of all, it's because that God felt that it's not good for the man to live alone.
神的旨意是让男女他们彼此成为对方的伴侣。
God's will is for the man and the woman to accompany one another as partner.
所以神在创造的时候预备了一个女人成为亚当的一个能够帮助他的伴侣。
So during the creation story, God has prepared woman as a partner for Adam.
让他们能够彼此的帮助。
So that they can support each other.
当然，一个重要的目的就是让他们能够繁殖生养。
Of course, another very important purpose is for them to reproduce.
使生命可以继续的延续下去。
So that life can continue on.
所以我们看到神设立了婚姻，原来是让我们能够继续的，就是传递生命下去。
So we see that the purpose God established marriage is actually for us to reproduce and ensure that our life can continue.
另外一个神就是让我们防止这个淫乱的发生。
Another purpose is for us to prevent adultery.
所以让我们避免这个情欲的试探。
And it's for us to prevent temptation of lust.
所以圣经很清楚的创世纪在哥林多里面就讲到男人当有自己的妻子。
In Corinthians, it was very clearly stated that every man should have his own wife.
女人当有各有自己的丈夫。
And every woman should have her own husband.
我们看到因为人独居不好，所以神让这个亚当有一个妻子夏娃。
So we see that because living alone is not good, so God gave Adam another partner, that is Eve.
另外一个第二点就是让他们能够成为彼此的帮助。
And another point is so that they can help one another.
因为神创造了宇宙万物。
Because God has created the universe.
这些万物是要让人来管理。
And these creations and all the living things require someone to manage it.
所以当他们夫妻开始生活的时候，他们彼此的互相的帮助来管理这个神所造的万物。
So when the husband and the wife comes together, they support one another in managing God's creation.
你会看到夫妻其实是一种彼此的祝福。
You can see that the spouse is a blessing to one another.
他们能够成为一种的互补的关系。
And they are able to complement one another.
所以你会发现夫妻间通常他们的性格都不一样。
So you also realize that as husband and wife, normally their characteristics are not the same.
很奇妙的就是我们通常碰到的就是 要不然妻子太外向，要不然丈夫就内向。
And very special in a way that sometimes we really face that we feel that our spouse and us, we are a total opposite characteristics. One is an extrovert, one may be an introvert.
所以你会看到各自的性格不同，但是为什么这两个人能够彼此的 相聚在一起呢？
So you see that our characteristics are all different, but how come, how can the two of us be together?
但是我们看到就是彼此的不同，才能够彼此帮助对方的缺点，或是帮助把缺点变成强点。
But then we see that it is because of our differences that we can complement one another and cover up each other's weaknesses.
比如, 其中一方是非常粗心。
For example, maybe one side is very careless and forgetful.
你会发现他遇到的另外一方很巧的, 这个是一个很细心的人。
And then, so happened that the spouse is someone who's very detailed.
那你会发现两种不同的性格，他们就互相帮助着对方，提醒着对方。
So you see that because they have two different characteristics, they're able to help one another.
另外一个神让他们觉得他们独居不好，成为彼此的帮助之外，还要他们建立家庭。
Other than being helped for one another, God also wants them to establish their family.
建立家庭就是在两个人里面，他们开始一个新的生活。
Establishing a family means that the two people will start a new life.
我们会发现以前我们都住在爸爸妈妈的家。
We know that last time, before we established our own family, we lived with our parents.
我们每一个人都有自己的生活习惯。
And we have our own habits in life.
可能承担责任不用这样重。
And maybe the responsibilities that we bear are not that big.
因为我们的父母会帮我们承担着所有的责任。
Because our parents will help share the responsibilities with us.
所以当我们设立一个家庭的时候,
But when we establish a family,
我们必须夫妻两人一起共同承担家庭的责任。
As husband and wife, we need to share the responsibilities of that family.
包括, 很多方面的, 各自的协调。
Including a lot of changes and adapting to the current situation.
以前的, 丈夫, 我的爸爸那个年代的丈夫是没有做家务的。
During the eras of my father's day, all the fathers, they do not have to do housework.
只有妻子做家务。
Only the wife will have to do all the housework.
但是我们看到, 到我们这个年代的时候, 我们知道了婚姻的意义的时候, 我们开始学习彼此承担家务。
But at this era, once we started to realize the meaning and the purpose behind marriage, we start to share our responsibilities.
我们共同的承担对家庭的责任。
We share the responsibilities towards our family.
另外一个我们也共同的教养孩子。
And another one is we also share together our responsibilities to raise and teach our children.
就是夫妻两人各自在家庭里面发挥自己的角色。
That is that the husband and wife will play their roles in the family.
好像做爸爸的就要发挥一个家庭领导的角色，给儿女做一个榜样。
For example, the father will become a role model as the leader of the family for the children.
然后做妻子的就要发挥一个角色，怎样帮助儿女，他们培养他们的生命，培养他们的品格。
And the wife will play the role of how to nurture the children, how to nurture good character into the children.
所以我们讲，当我们各自发挥自己的角色的时候， 这个家庭就是一个幸福的家庭。
So when we each play our respective roles in the family, then only this family is a happy family.
以前我们讲到男主外，女主内。
Last time we used to say that the husband will handle the outside and the wife will handle the inside.
但是因为现在经济环境的需要。
But because of the economy condition nowadays,
许多时候是两夫妻一起工作了。
Many times both husband and wife, they start working together.
所以当这个家里所有的家庭的责任就落在大家夫妻同一同来承担了。
And that makes all the responsibilities of the house to be shared by both the husband and the wife.
我讲一讲我跟 Ricky 我们的家庭。
Let me share about me and Ricky, brother Ricky's family.
以前 Ricky 也在家里没有做东西的。
Last time, brother Ricky also didn't do anything at home.
他只是负责帮忙我抹地。
So all he shared, all the responsibility he shared with me was to mop the floor.
后来我们有了孩子，他开始帮忙我承担家里的一些家务，比如照顾孩子啊，这些他都开始学习了。
But when we had children, he started learning how to take care of the children and also some of the household's chores.
到今天为止，我们在家里还是彼此的分工合作。
Until today, we still share our responsibilities and help one another out.
当然，抹地还是他的责任啊。
Of course, mopping the floor, he will still do it and it's his responsibility.
因为他觉得我抹得不干净。
Because he felt that when I mop the floor, it's not that clean.
家里煮饭呢，是由我煮，但是洗碗是他洗。
I will do the cooking in the house and Brother Ricky will do the cleaning and washing the dishes.
So, 我们看到夫妻间就是要彼此的帮助，彼此的看到彼此的需要。
So, we see that as husband and wife, we should help one another and also to see the weaknesses and the needs of our spouse.
另外，我们讲到夫妻间的相处到怎样的方法来相处呢？
And we also want to look at how do we get along with our spouse.
首先，夫妻必须有良好的沟通。
First of all, as husband and wife, we should have good communication.
良好的沟通方式是建立良好的夫妻关系的最基本原则。
And a good communication is the basic to building a good relationship between husband and wife.
你会发现有些人的沟通方式是用命令式的。
You find that some people, when they communicate with you, the type of communication they use is to order you.
当然那个是很难让对方满意啦。
Of course, that way is very hard for the other party to feel satisfied.
所以我们讲彼此的沟通方式，另外一个就是我们互相必须坦诚。
Another one is we should be honest with each other.
因为我们既然两人成为夫妻了，有什么需要隐瞒的呢？所以两人的坦诚是非常重要。
Because since we have become husband and wife, what is there to be kept a secret? So as husband and wife, we should be honest to one another.
所以互相的把心里所存在的一些问题不满就说出来了。
So feel free to share your feelings and your problems inside your heart.
不要把这些不满、这些心里的一些问题存着，一直积着、累积着，结果是变成一个大问题。
So do not keep all these feelings and emotions kept down in your heart, and then in the end, it will turn into a very big problem.
另外一个夫妻相处不要跟人家比较。
And as husband and wife, we should not compare with others.
尤其是我们讲女人会说，哎呀，别人的，你看对面的邻居赚这么多钱，你没有出息这样的话。
Of course, we want to say that as spouse, we cannot say that, wow, look at our neighbor, they are earning so much money, why are you not like them?
因为每个人的需要都不同。
Because everyone has different needs.
每一个人的能力也不同。
And everyone, their capabilities are different.
当能力不同的时候，我们知道我们只能按着我们的能力来进行我们的生活方式。
And when all the capabilities are different, we should work within what we are capable of.
不是别人有什么我必须有，而是我有没有这样的能力。
Not to say that whatever somebody else's have, I must have it as well.
当然作为丈夫也不能比较，哎呀，那个人比我的妻子漂亮，我的妻子以前是很漂亮，现在变成黄脸婆了。
Of course, as the husband, we cannot say that,well, the other person's spouse is much more beautiful. Of course, last time my wife was beautiful, but now she's no longer that beautiful.
所以我们会发现彼此能够到老，他们仍然彼此欣赏着对方，是其中一个重要的一个因素。
And a very important element is to be able to enjoy and appreciate one another until we grow old.
另外一个就是我们要接纳对方的软弱。
Another one is to accept each other's weakness.
我是一个比较不会牺牲的人，我拿了东西我会放在另外一边，我不会放回去的。
So I'm someone that is a lack of a system. Normally when I take something, I will not put it back to where it belongs.
但是经过这么多年跟 Ricky 相处，
But after getting along with Brother Ricky for so long,
因为 Ricky 是一个非常有秩序的人，那个东西放哪里就放回哪里去。
Because Brother Ricky is a very organized person, whatever the thing belongs to, it must be placed back to where it is.
所以这么四十年的相处，我也学习了怎样把东西组织好，放好好。
So in that 40 years of getting along with him, I have also learned how to put the things back at where they was.
我也受到他的影响了。
I was also affected by him.
他帮助我成长了。
And he has helped me to grow.
但是以前他要求很高哦，一点点一点点都不可以哦。
But last time he used to have very high expectations. Even a little bit of wrong, he doesn't take it.
我很痛苦哦。
I was suffering a lot.
但是呢，现在他也随便随便了。
But now he also start to be more lenient.
不再这么挑剔，不再这么说，一点点都不可以了。
He won't be so picky and about very very small differences or mistakes.
你会发现我们彼此之间夫妻间开始的在磨合啊。就是在摩擦的当中，但是我们彼此的接纳对方，彼此的成长。
You see that between the frictions that the husband and wife has together, we have become able to complement with one another and accept each other.
所以为什么说圣经讲说我们要彼此一起来建立家庭，就是让我们学习成长，学习怎样在家庭里面。承担起家庭的责任。
So that is why the Bible and the scripture says that we should establish a family that is actually for us to grow together and to accept one another.
我们讲到第三点就是说人要离开父母。
And the third point we want to talk about that people will leave their parents.
圣经讲的人要离开父母。
This is what the Bible has said.
就是说你已经成立了家庭，应该过一个独立自主的生活。
This means that you have already established a family and then you should live an independent life.
就是说你对你配偶的计划或者意见习惯，你要比对父母的意见更尊重。
So then you should start respecting more of your spouse's plan, their opinions,and their habits more than that of your parents.
我们以前在家每个作为儿女的都会听父母讲。
Last time as children, we will always obey what our parents want.
但是现在我们有了另外一半。
But now that we have a spouse,
我们要听听对方的意见，因为这个家是我们两个人的。
We need to listen to their opinion because this house now belongs to the two of us.
所以不论是有小事或者大事，都是由两个人来决定。
So no matter it's a small or a big matter, it's the decision that is between the two of us.
当然我们学习说我们不是仍然可以说不理父母，我们还是会关心父母。
But of course, we cannot just say that we do not want to care about our parents anymore. We still need to provide care for them.
但是我们不能说是依靠着父母，我们有自己的家庭，还要父母帮助我们的生活费啊，或者帮助我们做某一些东西。
But it is to say that we cannot keep relying on our parents and we should not no longer rely on them for our finance and for a lot of things in our family. Just between husband and wife, we should be able to be responsible for a lot of things and decisions in the family.
就是说我们可能父母一些的价值观现在不适合用在我们的家庭。
And that is also to say that maybe there are a lot of perspectives of our parents are no longer able to use it in our current family.
当然好的价值观是应该是继续的传递的。
Of course, if there are very good values, we should always continue on.
好像爸爸妈妈很相爱，当然我们要在我们的家庭，我们也要传递一个爱的观念。
For example, our parents are very loving to one another. So in our own family, we should also nurture this culture of love.
但是我们在情感上，我们还是跟我们的父母没有断绝的。
And we are still emotionally attached to our parents in a way.
也就是说，我们不能因为父母不喜欢我们的伴侣，或是我们的丈夫，或者是妻子，而试着改变我们要改变我们的伴侣来配合我们的父母的喜欢。
And we cannot say that because our parents do not like our spouse, so we want to force a change in them.
当然每个父母是希望我们的儿女能够嫁得好，好像我们的儿子能够娶一个贤妻良母。女儿能够嫁一个有钱人，有些父母是有这样的观念。
Of course, as parents, we want the best for our children. Certain parents, they want their daughter to marry a very rich husband, or the husband to marry a very good wife.
但是真正在我们生命里面，是我们要选择我们自己生命里面的伴侣。
But truly, in our life, we need to choose our spouse ourselves.
没有任何的金钱或者利益的存在。
They shouldn't be affected by any money or any benefits.
所以另外一个在人际关系中，我们要以丈夫或者妻子为首要的一个重要的一个生活观。
And also in our relationship, we should always prioritize our husband or our wife.
不管我们结婚之前怎样的在外面多么的自由自在，跟朋友想做什么就做什么。
No matter last time before getting into marriage, we were all outside, we were free, we can do whatever we want, we can spend our time with our friends.
但是我们结婚之后，我们成立了家庭之后，我们要向对方来交代，要向对方来做承担责任。
Now that we have gone through marriage, we must answer to one another and we must be responsible for one another.
所以你会发现我们开始没有像以前这样自由了。我去哪里要向我的伴侣来交代，我要交代我做了一些什么，这个是责任感。
So we realize that we are no longer that free to go anywhere we want because we need to answer to them, and this is what we call as responsibility.
另外一个我们看到婚姻关系除了两个人之外。
And as a marriage relationship, other than two people.
婚姻也牵连了对方的家庭。
It is also a family involvement.
包括他的家族每一个成员。
That includes every members in the other partner's family.
所以一段婚姻的建立是包括了对方整个的家庭。
So a normal,
整个的家族。
So a normal marriage relationship involves the other half's family members and all their relatives.
不单单只是两个人的不理其他家人的感受。
So it's not just between two people and you do not care about other family members' feelings.
所以我们发现当我们说我们要帮助我们的配偶进入一个我们的家庭。
So when we say that we want to help our spouse to enter into our family,
我们彼此不管是丈夫或妻子都要付上自己的努力。
So no matter is the husband or the wife, we should all play our part.
我们必须尽上自己的本分，来尽量跟对方的家人能够沟通，能够相处的融洽。
We must play our part to communicate effectively with the other family and also to get along well with them.
所以我们讲，至于我们怎样选伴侣呢？
And how do we choose a spouse?
我们看看圣经对基督徒婚姻的一个教导。
Let's look at the Bible's teaching on a Christian marriage.
我们看到这个必须是嫁到主里面的人。
And we see that, first of all, it must be someone that is in the Lord.
就在哥林多前书七章三十九节所说的。
That's in 1 Corinthians chapter 7, verse 39.
教导我们作为基督徒，当我们要选择我们生命的伴侣的时候，我们必须选择重生得救的信徒做我们生命的配偶。
And it teaches us that when we choose a person as our spouse, it should be a born-again believer.
另外就是选择这个讨主喜悦的爱神爱人的配偶。
And also to choose a partner that pleases the Lord, love God, and also love others.
最重要的就是在服侍者上面能够彼此的鼓励，彼此的劝勉。
And also a partner that are able to encourage or urge each other to serve God.
在婚姻的事上建立家庭里面，首先大家都必须承认以基督为主权的一个婚姻观。
In establishing marriage, everyone must first recognize the sovereignty of Christ.
另外一个讲，我们讲到婚姻其实是一种契约，或者说是盟约。
And we also say that marriage relationship is a covenant or is a contract.
圣经里面讲到婚姻的时候，讲到夫妻关系的时候，讲婚约呢，它的有效期是永远的。
And the marriage covenant, when mentioned by the Bible, is a covenant that is everlasting, that is forever.
直到其中的一方离开这个世界为止。
And it is until one of the couple passed away.
所以我们看到圣经讲的就是妻子不可离开丈夫。
So we see what the Bible says is that a wife must not leave her husband.
丈夫也不可离开妻子。
And a husband must not abandon his wife.
因为圣经讲两人成为一体。
Because the Bible says that the two has become one.
所以这两人是不可以分开的。
So these two people are inseparable.
所以马太福音19:6就说，夫妻不再是两个人，乃是一体了。所以神配合的人不可分开。
That's why Matthew chapter 19 verse 6 says, So they are no longer two, but one flesh. Therefore, what God has joined together, man must never separate.
所以我们看到真正这就是婚姻的价值观。
So this is the true perspective.Of a marriage.
如果我们说今天我们说我们是基督徒，我们有一个正确的婚姻的价值观，对我们来说是有一个帮助我们 彼此在婚姻里面建立更稳固的婚姻。
So today, as Christians, when we say that we have the correct and the right perspective on marriage, it will be able to help us to establish and to keep a very strong marriage.
So we see that when we say we have a solid marriage, it becomes an example for our children.
And when we have a very strong and very stable marriage, it's a very good example for our children.
我们讲，如果讲婚姻，如果出现了问题，今天我们作为基督徒，我们应该怎样来处理这些关系呢？
So when we talk about problems in marriage, as Christians, how should we handle it?
圣经明明讲两个人不可以分开。
So the Bible clearly says that the two are inseparable.
除非对方离开了这个世界。
Unless one of them pass away.
那么今天我们也讲，今天的时代，许多人的婚姻也面对了很大的挑战。
But we also see that today a lot of people face troubles in their marriage.
我们讲万一，好像我们说，比如一个信主，一个不信主，他们是在还没有信主之前，他们已经结婚了。
Or we can bring out an example. For example, this husband and wife, before they were married, before they were Christians, they were already married.
现在其中的一方成为基督徒了。
And now one of them accepted Christ.
那么他们应该怎样相处下去呢？
How can the two of them get along and continue on?
圣经告诉我们说，即使他们对方没有信主，但是我们不可因为对方而没有信主而离开他。
The Bible tells us that although the other party, our spouse have not accepted Christ, we cannot say that because they have not accepted Christ, we are leaving them.
因为我们不知道这个人几时会信主。
Because we can never know when will this person come to Christ.
所以我们只能耐心等候。
So we can only patiently wait.
我们只能等候，我们只能祷告，我们只能用我们的生命的见证来影响对方，带领他能够认识主。
We can only wait patiently and we can only pray and use our life testimony to draw them to Christ.
而不能说因为对方没有信主现在我信了主，我不能跟他在一起了。
We cannot say that, wow, this person, I'm already a Christian, this person is not a Christian, so I cannot be with him anymore.
所以我们是尽量说，我们在我们还没有进入婚姻的时候，我们要教导我们的弟兄姐妹，必须清楚的考虑，如果对方还没有信主，我们应该怎样帮助带领他来到认识主呢？
So we want to continue to encourage and also to educate our own brothers and sisters that even before entering into marriage, if your other half has not accepted Christ, how should we bring him to Christ or her to Christ?
这可能是一个等待的过程，有可能很短，也有可能很长。
This may be a very long period, or it may be a very short waiting period.
但是我们仍然要持守神对婚姻的教导。
But we still want to uphold what the Bible teaches about marriage.
就是丈夫不可离开妻子，妻子不可离开丈夫。
That is, the husband should not abandon his wife, and the wife must not leave her husband.
两人继续的在婚姻里面继续维持夫妻的关系。
The two of them continue to uphold and maintain their relationship as husband and wife.
我们需要神给我们很大的恩典，因为我们的责任是把对方带到神的面前。
We truly need God to give us a lot of grace because we want to bring our other half to Christ.
所以今天我们讲的就是神设立的婚姻，是因为神不要人独居。
Today we say that God has established marriage because God do not want man to live alone.
他要我们成为彼此的帮助。 让女人成为丈夫的帮助，也让丈夫成为妻子的帮助。
He wants the wife to be able to be the help for the husband, and also the husband to be able to be a help for the wife.
另外一个就是教导我们必须离开父母。
Another one is to teach us to leave our parents.
然后我们自己建立自己的婚姻，然后我们彼此维持自己的婚姻，成立一个新的家庭。
And then we establish our marriage, and also we establish our own family.
然后我们在我们的家庭里面维持我们良好的婚姻关系。
And then in our family, we maintain a very good marriage relationship.
承诺我们当初结婚的时候对婚姻的那种承诺跟盟约。
And we keep our promise and the covenant that we have made when we enter into marriage.
然后我们尽上自己的责任，在家庭里面办好做妻子、丈夫的责任，父亲、母亲的责任。
And in our family, we play our part in our role and responsibilities as husband, wife, father, and mother.
所以我们一起加油。还没有选择到伴侣的人，我们更要更清楚地选择我们自己的伴侣。
So those who are still looking for a spouse, we need to work hard and to know that we need to pray about it and to wait for it.
就是要选择在主里面的人，就是爱主、爱神、爱人的人，能够跟你一起在服事里面配搭的人。
And we also need to look for the spouse that love God and love people and that can help us and encourage us in our serving.
至于我们已经在婚姻关系里面的，
and to those of us who are already in marriage,
我们就要持守我们对婚姻的一个委身。
We must uphold our commitment in our marriage.
我们对婚姻的一个盟约，当初我选择了这个人。我就是跟他一生一世了。
Our covenant during our marriage that when we have chosen our partner, we are going to live with them until the end.
所以我们基督徒在婚姻的时候有立一个盟约，不论生与死，不论富贵贫穷，不论疾病，都不能把我们彼此的分开，我们都要彼此的珍惜着对方。
So as a husband and wife, we made a covenant during our marriage that no matter if we are in a rich state or a poor state, or when we are in sickness or we are in any kind of situation, we will never leave one another. This is the covenant and the promise that we have made.
下个礼拜我们是母亲节。
So next week is our Mother's Day.
所以我们会有母亲节的信息。
And we will have a message, especially for the Mother's Day.
所以接下来再多一个星期是我们讲到我们对于婚姻的一些观点，圣经怎么说一些婚姻呢？应该怎样维持一些婚姻？对于一些特别的个案，我们应该怎样处理呢？
And the week after, we will talk about a lot of the views of marriage from the Bible's perspective, and we'll talk about how to manage and how to handle some issues regarding marriage.
让我们一起来祷告。
Let us pray.
爱我们的天父，我们谢谢你。
Father who loves us, we thank you.
我为着我水堂所有的家庭来感谢。
We thank you for every single family in Living Water Assembly.
所有的夫妻来感谢主。
Thank you for every single husband and wife.
我们感谢神，有些已经完全家人都已经得救了。
We thank you that some of them, the whole household has already been saved.
我们求主继续的坚固我们每一个活水堂弟兄姐妹们的婚姻。
We pray that God, you continue to strengthen the marriage of every single brothers and sisters in Living Water.
尤其在这个冠状病毒这个禁止令的期间。
Especially in this lockdown period.
我们需要大家都 更多的时间接触的时候
when we have more time to be with one another,
我们求主帮助我们，我们对家人更多的付出，更多的爱。
We pray that may God help us that we can commit and we can love our family more.
在这段期间，也让我们夫妻间更好的珍惜着对方。
And also that in this period that we as husband and wife, we can appreciate more of one another.
还有珍惜我们身边的，我们的父母，我们的儿女。
And to appreciate our father, our mother, and our children.
我们谢谢你。
We thank you.
我们也为这还没得救的弟兄姐妹们的伴侣来祷告。
For our brothers and sisters, our spouse who have not accepted Christ, we want to pray for them as well.
求主敞开他们的心，好叫这些弟兄姐妹他们的伴侣能够有一天能够认识耶稣。
God, may you open their hearts so that one day they can come to know you.
好叫正如圣经所说的，至于我和我全家，必要侍奉耶和华。
Just as the scripture has said, as for me and my household, we will serve the Lord.
求主帮助我们在这段疫情的时间，我们更加的能够成为夫妻间最好的一个沟通的一个桥梁。
That Lord, you help us that in this lockdown period, we can, as husband and wife, be able to establish a very effective and good communication with one another.
主啊，我们求主坚固每一个夫妻，每一对的夫妻。
Lord, may you strengthen every couple.
不管是外面世界任何的试探，我们都求主远帮助我们远离这所有的试探。
No matter what temptation is there out in the world, Lord, help us to get away and to protect us from this temptation.
让我们每一对夫妻都成为彼此的祝福。
So that we as husband and wife, we become a blessing for one another.
让我们彼此的相爱，直到我们见主的面为止。
So that we continue to love one another until we meet you once again.
主啊，我们谢谢你。
Lord, we thank you.
祝福我们的弟兄姐妹。
Bless our brothers and sisters.
他们的家庭和谐。
That their family will be at peace.
他们夫妻彼此能够借着他们的婚姻能够荣耀神。
And husband and the wife, through their marriage and family, they can give you glory.
好叫世人看到我们基督徒的婚姻是被上帝所祝福的。
That let the world see that the marriage of the Christians, we are being blessed by our God.
求主帮助我们将持守婚姻的盟约。
Lord, help us to uphold this covenant in our marriage.
我们谢谢主耶稣你对我们家庭的祝福。
Lord, we thank you for the blessings of our family.
和带领。
And the guidance in our family.
我们奉耶稣基督的名来祷告。
In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
奉耶稣的名祝福大家都有美满幸福的婚姻。
Bless everyone with a happy and a blessed marriage in the name of Jesus.
因为上帝把对方放在你的生命里面，一定有美好的旨意。
Because God definitely has His perfect will when He put your partner into your life.
不要只是看对方的缺点。
Do not just look at the other half's weaknesses.
也要看对方的优点。
But also look at their benefits and their advantages.
我们期待我们很快能够见面。
I truly hope that we can meet one another face to face.
看到马来西亚的情况好像是越来越好了。
And I see that the condition in Malaysia has gotten better.
希望五月份这个禁止令能够完全的消除了。
We hope that the movement control will be able to be lifted up once the month of May ends.
请大家继续的为这个疫情祷告，也为我们马来西亚的执政者祷告，让他们知道什么时候是最好的开放，求主保守马来西亚。
And continue to pray for the pandemic, continue to pray for our country, for Malaysia's government, so that they know when is the right time and how to handle the lifting up of the MCO.
好，上帝祝福大家。
All right, God bless everyone.
Thank you for joining our online service. 谢谢你们参与我们的线上聚会。This is our announcement for this week. 这是我们这星期的报告。We will have our online service on every Sunday, 10 a.m.Tune in to our YouTube Live and our channel Living Water AG Tambin. 我们将在每逢星期日早上十点直播我们的线上聚会，大家可以到我们的 YouTube 频道 Living Water AG Tambin 收看。
We will have our Zoom online prayer every Wednesday at 8 p.m. See you in the Zoom app.
我们将在每个星期三晚上八点进行线上祷告，大家一起在 Zoom APP 见。
We encourage everyone to join the online cell group.You can inquire more info from your respective cell leaders.
教会鼓励大家能够继续参与线上小组，你们可以向各自小组组长获取更多资讯。
Although we are in the lockdown period, we can still tithe and give offering via online banking. Kindly email your banking slip to church or WhatsApp to Sister Sharon Lai.
虽然现在是封城的时间，大家还可以透过网上银行支付十一奉献。请在奉献后把银行收据电邮给教会，或者信息给赖金兰姐妹。
That is all for our announcement this week. See you next week. God bless you.
我们这星期的报告就到此为止，我们下个星期见。上帝赐福于大家。